Hello everyone, this is Harsh and you are watching WPF World. In this video, I will first create the WPF application with MVVM and then I will convert WPF application to Prism application. Let's understand what is MVVM. The full form of MVVM is Model View View Model. MVVM is a way of creating client application that leverages core feature of the WPF platform. Allows for simple unit testing of application functionality and help developer and designer work together with less technical difficulties. What is model? Model contains the set of properties that are going to show on the user interface. In most cases, the models are entity framework generated from the database. What is view? View is defined in XAML and should not have any logic in code behind. It binds the view model by only using data binding. What is view model? It acts as a link or connection between the model and view and make stuff look pretty. The view model is middle layer that contains all business logic. Let's create the new project. Okay, so go to file menu and select new and then click project. Okay, here search for WPF application. If you can see here, we have C sharp window desktop. Because I am going to use the C sharp, so I will select this C sharp and set the name of the project. I will say WPF to Prism. Okay. I will change the location here. Okay. I want to save in WPF project folder, so I selected this path here. I will click on next. Okay. Here I will select anything what we have .NET Core 3.1. I will select .NET Core 3.1. Okay. And I will click on create. It will create the WPF application for us. Okay. If you can see, we have main window. If you can see in Solution Explorer, there is app.xml assembly info main window. Because I am going to use the MVVM pattern, so I will create three folders. The first folder called view, where we will have all the UI. And second, I will create model. And now we have view models. Let's create it. Now let's open app.xml. You can see here startup URI is set to main window.xml. I don't want to keep the main window here. I want to move it to views because I want to have all the UI in views. So I will move it. Okay. Let's move to view model. And if you can see here, this is not changed. So I will change it. If you can see here, the namespace of this is WPF to Prism, but I want to change it to view. WPF Prism inside view we have. So I will change it to view. Here also I will change. Okay. And inside the CS we have to change the namespace .views. Okay. I will remove all this thing because it is not required for now. So remove it, save it, and we'll try to run it. See, it is showing can't locate resource main window.xml because we have not change the path here. Let's change it. Okay, now let's run it. If you can see, it is showing main window. Okay. Now I will add some control here in the UI. I will add text block. I will say text to welcome to WPF. World. Okay. Let's run and see. Yeah, perfect. You can see this text. Now I will create the view model for main window. So I will name it as main window view model. Let's add one class. Okay. Main window view model. Okay. I will add some property here. So I will use prop full. Okay. I will add string now. Text text to display. Okay. Now what I am going to do, I am going to set the data context of the window. So how to set it? Data context equal to new. I will set to view model object. Okay. Main window. View model. Okay. Now I will remove this hard-coded text from the UI and I will assign it to property. So I will bind that property to this text. What is that property name? Text to display. This public property we have to bind. Binded it. Now let's run and see the result. See, if you can see, we have welcome to WPF world. You can see here. Means binding is working properly. Let's add some control and check the binding part. I will add one text box here. Okay, and we'll bind with the same property. I want to check if UI is updating on property change or not. So I will make it as stack panel, orientation as vertical. Okay, let's run it and see the result. This is text block. Let me change text block to text box. Let's run and see the result. If you can see, text box also contains the same text. Now what I want to do, I want to change this text in text box and it should change in text block as well. If you can see here, I am changing this, but it is not changing the text block text. So how to fix that? To update the UI, we have to implement the iNotify property change to the main view model. Okay, let's implement it. We have implemented the iNotify property change. Here you can see, on implementation of iNotify property change, the public event property change, event handler property change is added. This property change will update the UI if the property is changed. So we have to call this. How we can do that? Let's create one method which will call this property change method. Public void on property change. Okay. Here we'll take parameter as property name, which property we are going to check. Here we'll check if property change event is not null. Not null, then invoke it so that UL will reflect. Okay. Let's pass the required parameter here. The first argument will be the current class instance. The second parameter will be the property change event args. Okay. So let's pass it. In this object, we have to pass the property, which property we are going to update on property change. So now we have to call this on property change method in the setter of the property. So let's call it on property change. And we have to pass the name of the property. Okay. Like this name of. What is the property name? Text to display. Okay. Let's run and see the result. If you can see here, both have same text. I am going to change. It's not reflected, right? So let's see what happened. We have to set here how we want to update the UI. To do that, we have to use this update source trigger to property change. So that once the property will change, it should reflect. Let's run and see. Let's remove it. When we are removing from here, it's also removed from the text block. Let's type something. It's also reflect the text block text. If you observe here, I have not created any model here. I have added all the property inside the view model. Let's create the model and move this property to model. I will add the class and give the name as main window model. Okay. Let's move all these properties. Now I will remove this thing from here. Okay, we have to have this iNotify property change implementation here. As I explained earlier, model contain the set of properties. And view model act as a connection between the view and model. So the view model should have the model. So let's create the property for the model. I will create the full property. of the type modal, which is main window modal. We'll give name as a modal. I will call on property change to the setter of the modal. Let's call it on property change. Name of property name. What is the property name? Modal. Let's fix this. Here also I need to fix. Okay. Now it's time to bind. How to bind the modal to the view. So what I will do here now, I will pass the modal object here. Like I will do modal dot. So it will bind to the modal property. Same thing I will do here. Let's run and see the result. If you can see, it is not binded. So let's see what's happened. We have to initialize the modal object. Okay, now let's run and see the result. If you can see, we can see the value of the text property. Now let's change and see if it reflects the text block text or not. If you can see here, I have removed the value and it's removed from text box. Okay, now it's time to convert the WPF application to Prism application. To convert to the Prism application, we have to add some dependency. Okay, so go to the dependency and select the manage NuGet package. Go to browse and search for Prism. Install this required package. I will install first prism.core. Click on OK. If you can see here, this package is installed, prism.core. So now let's install the WPF, prism.wpf. Now click on OK. Let's see in dependency if it is installed successfully or not. Okay, you can see it is installed successfully and we can see prism.core and prism.wpf inside the packages. Now it's time to change the code for converting WPF application to Prism application. First, I will go to app.jml and I will add the namespace of Prism library. Now I will replace application with Prism application. And I will remove the startup URI from here. Now we have to replace this as well. Okay. Now I have to replace app.jml.cs application to Prism application. Now let's fix it. It is asking to install the prism.unity, but I will not use the unity. I will use Prism dot dry IOC. So let's search for prism.dryioc. I will install this package prism.dryioc. Let's install it. Click on OK to install all this thing. Click on I accept. Okay, now let's see installation explorer. You can see it is installed successfully. Now let's go to app.jml.cs and fix it. Okay. We have to override some abstract class methods. Okay. Here I will return the window which we want to show as a startup UI. I will use return new. I want to return main window. I will not do anything here. Now let's run and see the result. Right, you can see the text here. It's working correctly. Now I will modify the view model. I will remove this iNotify property change from here. And I will replace it with bindable base. So let's fix it using prism.mvvm. Now we don't have to implement this thing and we don't have to write this method here. We have to call just set property. It requires reference to a property. So I will give ref model. Okay, and it's required value for the property. Now let's remove this. If you can see how many code we removed from here. In the same way, I will do in model. Let's do it. Let's remove this and run and see the result. Let's remove something, but if you can see, it's not reflecting here. Issue is here because we are initializing first and then calling the set property method. The set property will first compare text and the value. If it is equal, then it will not notify the UI. That's why it's not operating the UI. So I will remove this line. And same thing I will do from here. Okay, now let's run and see the result. Okay, let's remove something. Okay. If you can see, it is working correctly. If you can see here, I have set the data context in the main window gmail.cs like this, but in Prism application we can do it from the gmail file itself. So how to do that? First we have to add the namespace for Prism. Let's add it. Now I will make use of view model locator Prism dot view model locator dot auto wire model equal to true. What it will do, it will search for view model inside the view models folder, and the view model name should be the name as a view. Like in this case, we have main window as a view, and view model should be main window view model. Now let's run and see the result. You can see the result is same. Perfect. It's working fine. I hope you got the idea how to convert WPF application to Prism application.